that's right. They still have crew loss. Been forever since I played this. The Inquisition. Oops. Wrong button. Ugh. Alright, we're live. Welcome everybody that wants to come in and see some more Battlefleet Gothic action. So I switched back to my Imperials. I was tired of playing fucking orcs and shit. So we're heading off, though it might start a new admiral just so I don't have to do these huge fights. I don't know, we'll see. Not 100%. We shall have to see. See how boogie it is today. What is it? Breakthrough. I'm the defender. Nope, that's all I got. I'll go with it and see what happens. Screw it. So apparently Eldar is supposed to be released on Friday, according to a friend of mine who trolls the forums. So definitely be playing that on this on Friday and giving them a try. See how they play. No, still waiting on the leader. Maybe he didn't connect, or he doesn't want to choose a fleet, I guess. Didn't want to choose his ships. So what, this will be the 4-point defense. Got four little gun platforms or whatever. Come on, ready up, dude. We got shit to play. Do-do-do-do-do. Waiting on the other guy. Ugh. Not a lot to say when you're just waiting in queue. 20 more seconds. Rot rat sushi? That doesn't sound very tasty. Just gonna go out on a limb and say that would probably taste disgusting. Okay, there we go, I guess. Alright, we're here. Look how big that fucking Emperor class battleship is. Ginormous! Defend the platform and repel the enemy. Dun 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 dun. Alright. We will start right here. First, auto our platforms. There is four of them. And they have to take out all four before they can try and get to the retreat thing. Which gives me plenty of time to focus their engines. Or else they'll just get outside my range. Assault boats, brace for impact. I'm actually going to switch this to shorter range. Do that, that, that. No, I don't have to do that actually. Don't want that to auto. Lightning strike. Auto the Nova Cannon. Automate the Terminator lightning strikes and all that. Alright. I guess my Dominator saw. At your command. I guess my Nova Cannon saw the enemy.
Yes, Admiral. Awaiting orders.
Launch out some fighter squadrons. I didn't never looked at the Imperial fighters. Not very good. Orc ones look much better.
Enemy ship sighted!
Okay. So, there's three of them. Did he launch another gas cone? No.
Awaiting orders.
Man, these battleships look awesome. I might switch to the Retribution. I'm not 100%.
Enemy ship sighted.
Not entirely sure if I'm gonna switch to the Retribution or not. So that's all he brought, huh?
Orcas collapsing, sir! We lost a defense platform!
Nova cannon to my own platform. Good job, guys.
Ship ready. Ship ready. At your command.
Turn, big boy.
Ship ready.
Alright, so they're taking some damage, but not much.
Enemy ship sighted!
No, stop that.
Your orders?
Enemy ship sighted!
Terminator, failure.
Yes, Admiral.
Stop doing that!
Yes, Admiral. Ship crippled, Admiral. We lost the defense platform.
Oh wow, it's actually going pretty well for them. That got rather well. That worked out better than expected.
Your orders?
Okay, just warp out. Yeah, I win.
Yes, Admiral. Brace for impact.
I got one. Not great, but it's something. Good start with a victory. Yay, and he gets crew bonuses this time. Yes. All right, back out there. Oh, wait. How much is it? It's like 1,200 or something. 1,600. Oof. Could put a favor on one of these. Yeah, we'll just hold off. Save. Save up them points. Alright, assassination attacker. Great. It's only 450 points, though. Let us see. I almost want to take just light cruisers. And okay. Why is it? I don't understand why the sword is more expensive. The only thing it changes is the weapon loadout. But there's no point. Destroy the targeted admiral's ship. It's a cruiser. Looks like it has a Nova cannon. Alright. That. Brace for impact, Terminator assault.
Enemy ship sighted. Engaging.
I'm sad I only have one Nova cannon. Boy, he brought a lot of frigates, I assume. Probably ram ships. Alright, I need to actually not have that on auto so that I can use it at the proper time. Alright, you're just gonna hide it in the back, huh? That's okay. That is a strategy. Wow, that firestorm took it right to the face. Good job, Captain.
Enemy ship sighted! Race for impact!
We will just blow right through.
We are the Imperial Navy. Brace for impact. Feel the wrath of the Imperial Navy.
Oh, there goes my
Imperial escort destroyed! Awaiting orders. Acquiring new vector. Targeting
turret
enemy
destroyed.
Vessel. At your command. Execute high energy turn. Cruising speed set. Ship ready.
Solid hit.
Brace for impact.
What the hell are you guys doing?
Course plotted. Damage teams, begin repairs now.
don't think
awaiting orders.
I'm gonna be able to catch him.
Target locked in. Brace for impact.
Lost my Nova Cannon.
Ship ready. For the Emperor. We've lost one of our ships. The Navigator will guide us out. Yes, and this was your last chance, Captain. Initiate emergency repairs. Ship ready. We are the Imperial Navy.
Execute.
The punishment for disobedience.
At your command.
Death. Engines to maximum.
Whoosh.
Cruising speed set.
The flagship has been destroyed.
Yep, guess it's time to get out of here. That thing was tough, mother. Nukeum. Nukeum? Nukeum? Welcome to the stream. Glad you could join me tonight. Oh, Lost Dwarf Prince. Okay, I was trying to read that. I was like, Lots? What? Welcome you to the stream. I went back to Imperial. I got tired of playing Chaos and getting my ass kicked, and orcs, kind of fun. Not really my thing. Looking forward to Eldar, though. Not really my thing, but I gotta at least try them out. So, that'll be Friday, though. Nothing we can do before that, obviously. So, someone that's the Adeptus Mechanicus? Nope. That was a waste of points. Dude, this one's not the cheap. Oh yeah, this one has another upgrade slot. I forgot about that. I like the Adeptus Mechanicus one. When the game launches, I might just make all of the Adeptus Mechanicus ships. They look fucking boss. Yeah, let's add some extra void shields. Because more shields is good. Alrighty, that didn't go so well, so let's get back out there. Let us continue the fight. Be patient? I don't know, I'm not a great gamer by any stretch of the imagination, no MLG here, but really it's a... kind of finding a good mix. Like with the Imperials, you've got, you can pick a lot of torpedoes, or you can go with a lot of Nova cannons, or, you know, aircraft is kind of Chaos's thing because they don't have torpedoes, but they got long range lances. It's just about knowing the strengths and weaknesses of your fleet, you know, where your ships kind of excel. Upgrading with your strategy in mind. So, you know, if you want to go faster, if you want to pick a Chaos fleet and go faster, you pick the upgraded engines for your ships and that kind of stuff. Fuck, where's a good spot to deploy? But really, if you're looking to really kind of test yourself, like, you know, kind of ease your way into it, first of all, do the, obviously the, you know, beginning tutorial or whatever, so you got at least a basic idea of, you know, what's going on. And then if you're really worried about it, I would say go fight some like bots. Assault craft. I don't even know who I'm up against. Chaos. Fuck, I'm up against Chaos. I'll never catch him. That's the thing, Chaos, I can never catch them, so they'll just kite me around the map. This whole time, and shoot at me with lances. Oop, not the other one. Nova Cannon good, Nova Cannon good. Okay. But, it's gonna be a pretty steep learning curve. Like, the orcs can't do, you know, high speed turn or high energy turns. I'd say so, but, you know, I've played a bunch, but I'm still not that great. So. Yeah, knowing what your ships can do, like, if you're Chaos, you don't want to get within, like, you know, you don't want to get right up close to the, like, Imperial ships or Orc ships, just because they're a lot tougher than you are, and you'll get mauled at close range. You want to, you know, try and stay away from them. You know, use your extra long-range lances to your advantage to do damage outside of where they can effectively hit you. And then if they get close, you know, you can get away from them because you're faster. The Orcs... You want to get in and board, you know, have boarding actions and lightning assaults going. The Imperials, you want to use your, you know, your enhanced frontal armor, since we have armored prows here, and either Nova Cannons or torpedoes. I prefer Nova Cannon just because it's more automatic. You know, Nova Cannon, you know, point shoot. Like, I have mine set on auto, so they'll go off here
your
in a second.
Orders?
But... You know, torpedoes can be very, very deadly. And here they go, whoosh! But I mean, at this range, they're probably gonna miss. Oh, no, there was a solid hit. So I only see four of them to my five, so. But there's probably a battleship, you know, two battlecruisers, and you know, some. I should have thrown some fighters out.
Yes, Admiral.
Alright, got my fighter squadrons launched. Awaiting you are orders. In a freaking asteroid field like a dummy. Okay, yeah, they have a despoiler battleship. Or desolator.
Setting course.
Not sure why he stopped way out there, but. So, as Chaos, I want to focus his engines. Because I'm not gonna catch him.
Get ready! Burn retros! Yes, Admiral.
So, definitely ensuring that I take out his engines in some form or fashion is a good idea for me.
Your orders? Brace for impact.
Alright, that one is all launch bays.
Awaiting orders.
Oh, I got his engine. Sweet. Alright, now focus weapons. Nice.
Your orders?
That went much better than I thought it was going
to. All ahead, pull! Enemy ship sighted. We've lost an escort ship.
Oh no, lost my frigate. Yeah, and also, I'm not sure why he stopped.
Race for impact.
Damn it.
Enemy ship sighted. Understood. Cruising speed set. Race for impact. Yes,
yeah, not
Admiral.
Sure exactly why that.
Acquiring new vector. Cruising speed set. At your command.
Yeah, very kind of a strange thing going on here.
Targeting enemy vessel.
Yeah, why a Chaos player is sitting still is beyond me.
Ready. Execute high energy turn. Cruising speed set. execute high energy turn.
My Emperor's probably gonna go down though. Which sucks, but.
Engaging.
Oh wow, I took out his generator, it looks like. Nice.
Yes,
or no, not generator, deck. Very, very unusual.
The navigator will guide us.
No? Go screw yourself? No!
Orders. We are the Imperial Navy!
Actually.
Changing course.
Why? Okay, my ship is stuck in warp transit.
Your orders?
Awesome.
Target locked in.
Awesome. So can't do anything without with that. So Emperor's gonna go down.
Brace for impact. Ship ready. Burn retros! Cruising speed set.
So,
warp engine active. Yes, Admiral.
I guess his battleship either ran away or X'd out. There went my Emperor. Seriously, I think it's blown up constantly. So I guess I win?
Yes, Admiral.
Okay, I won, I guess. Probably should have just let my Emperor run away. I didn't do that much damage to his battleship. I don't know why he ran off. Mm. Okay, that's probably not a good example of how chaos is supposed to be used. Letting Imperial ships savage them at close range with macro batteries. Not a good move. Also, Blight01, welcome to the stream, by the way. Also, you Nukem, in case I didn't say hi. Not 100% if I did or not. That was the only ship I lost, though, so, I mean, that's good, at least. Could have been far worse. Okay, so still saving up for 1600 renown so I can put a favor on my battleship. Can I? I can't switch until it's... I don't even remember how to switch. There's a way you can switch, but I forgot. Nope. Oh. It's just, it has torpedoes. But, I don't know. It's not really any different. It's a little bit faster than the Emperor is. Same number of turrets, same troop values, same... No, it's got... Oh, that's what the Emperor's got. It's... Oh, that was right on the tabletop. It had, like, advanced sensor suite or something on the prow instead of a weapon. I remember that now. And it doesn't have an armored prow, either. Huh. So there are a few differences between the two. I didn't realize that. Huh. I don't know. I guess I'll stick with the Emperor for now, but... I'm still kind of debating whether I want to keep it or go for the retribution. The not so great sequel to the original Dawn of War. But, I don't know. I'll think about it. I've been debating it for a while now. I thought I hit the search button. There we go. Sorry, I'm dumb. Apologies, everyone. Alright, let's see. So, won against Chaos, lost against the Orcs. Data recovery, fuck. Extra fuck against Orcs. Oops. Okay, make that my admiral ship. And then bring the firepower. All the Nova cannons. Okay, and I'm hoping that if I have my light cruiser as the admiral, I'll be able to keep him the hell away from the orcs. But we'll see how that goes. My plans don't usually go as I'd like them to. It's weird having them focus around my light cruiser when there's battle cruisers escorting it. Warp out with the data. No real good. Actually, if I do this, I can put the rest over here. Do that. Firestorm. Always be sure for like your firestorms, if they have a prowl weapon, then be sure. Actually, not a good mode to auto cast your assaults. And this one's because you need them for stealing the data back, essentially.
Your command. Ship ready.
Wow. Apparently he brought every fucking ship in the fleet. Though it doesn't look like they're moving.
Your orders?
Helm coordinates acknowledged.
Fortunately they
enemy
fixed
ships
that,
sighted.
The whole Grot cannon issue.
Enemy ship sighted!
So they can't steal it from the other side of the
setting
map.
Setting course. Awaiting orders. Engines to maximum.
Cruising speed set.
Wow, he brought a lot of savage gunships.
Engaging. Awaiting orders.
And we took out that engine. Nice.
Race for impact.
He has a tractor beam cannon.
Your order. Brace for impact. At your command. Targeting enemy vessel. Changing course. Brace for impact.
All right. That is 369. So he had like 12 savage gunships.
Ship ready.
Oh, he's obviously forgotten that Light Dauntless over here has the data. So that's okay though. We'll just run
underway. Ship ready.
So he's got 3 light cruisers.
Engines hot. Target locked in.
Shit.
One of our ships is gone, sir.
Get out of here with your tractor beam nonsense.
Engaging.
Your orders.
Awaiting orders. Understood. Brace for impact. Brace for impact. Ship ready.
That's pretty crazy. That many friggin' gunships. Took out my lance.
We lost the data. Information secured. Setting course.
There goes that.
One of our ships is gone, sir. engines hot.
Yes, Admiral.
Let's see if we can get out of here. Unlikely.
Awaiting orders.
Acquiring new vector. Ship ready.
Ah, made it. Yes. Your 12 savage gunships didn't save you today. Oh, thanks, Lost Dwarf Friends. You're awesome. Thanks for the follow. I appreciate it. Don't always do Battlefleet Gothic, obviously, as you can probably tell if you've taken 3 seconds to look at my stream. But today I was like, I'm playing Battlefleet Gothic. I've been playing Orcs Must Die for the last couple days. Fun times. That sucks. I lost a battlecruiser and a cruiser out of that. I hope that data was worth it, motherfuckers. That data better be worth its price in like a million ships. Alright. So, we're actually not terribly far. If we keep grinding at it, we should be able to have a favor on my battleship in no time. Orcs. Alright, Blight. How do I feel about them? Interesting. They look very good. I know that's not really what you're asking, but the aesthetics look really cool. I like the look. They can't do high energy turns, which sucks. So I don't like that because it doesn't fit my playstyle. They can hit really hard. They're good at ramming. As you saw in that last match we were just in, one of their favorites gives them like a tractor beam gun. Data recovery? Fuck. So they get like a tractor beam. They can also get Nova cannons, and they get lots of torpedoes. They don't have a lot of lance weapons. Well, they are orcs. Indeed, they are orcs. They are the slowest ships, so that can be kind of an issue depending on what you're trying to do. Pretty inaccurate guns, but I think they get extra boarding actions or lightning assaults or something. Not exactly sure which one. I forget. I was playing them. I played them up to like level 3 or 4, but they can be pretty fun. So they're enjoyable. But this is gonna suck because I don't think I'm ever gonna catch the guy. I'm not a big fan of data recovery, either attack or defense, because like Chaos, he didn't put it on a light cruiser, which was surprising. But I don't know if there's any actual difference in speed for them. I didn't look when I was playing Chaos, but just like it's Chaos and it's freaking. This is my dictator that has let's just do this. Assault boats, Nova cannon. Don't auto your assaults in this case, just because I need them for the constant data stealing that we're gonna have going on. Okay. Let's see where he is and go for it. The only plus side is my
enemy ship sighted. Oh. Awaiting orders.
Turn, you bitch, turn. Whew. Uh-oh. Looks like my ships
at
are
your
sliding.
Command.
That's not. So, yeah, now he's, moving away, and, unlikely for me to catch. So this will probably be a pretty short match of me trying to chase him across the map. No shit, I'm identified. I'm high speed burning at somebody. don't know that that really did anything, but it looked cool.
Brace for impact!
Tyranids would be interesting, because their ships are, if I remember correctly, like in tabletop, they were like melee kind of ships. But,
Feel the wrath of the Imperial Navy!
There's the one I need. And again, I'm never gonna catch the motherfucker.
At your command.
You could also have Tau, possibly. Unless I get really lucky and take out his engines, I'm never gonna catch the guy.
Brace for impact.
We could also what the hell is going on with my cruiser? Why are you going sideways? This game's still a slightly buggy. What the fuck? So that ship's a toned-down Necron fleet. I remember reading on forums that basically the Necrons were the bane of everyone's existence. Alright, my one ship is gone full stupid.
Your orders! Awaiting orders!
Yeah, so a toned down Necron fleet where they're actually killable? That would probably be good.
Your orders? At your command.
Yeah. Totally not gonna catch him. Yep, he's already warping out. And playing against Chaos is BS.
Enemy ship sighted!
So. There we go. He wins because he can just run away faster. Then I can catch him. So, not a big fan of a lot of these mission types. I think a Tau fleet might be interesting, but I don't know how they would. I don't really know how they were different on tabletop. So that one might be interesting, but I have no idea what they're going to add beyond the Space Marines, which we know about, and then when they push back the release date to later this month, they announced also they were going to give another DLC fleet to early adopters. So, and they haven't announced what that one's going to be yet, though. So we will have something. I don't know when, but we'll have two fleets. This is my dictator. So we'll have to wait and see what beyond the five fleets we know about will be. I mean, there's quite a few they could add. Yeah, Necrons, Tyranids, the Tau. I don't ever think we're going to get like a Rogue Trader fleet, and I've been almost... Forge World tried to introduce what the Dwayne fleet or whatever, you know, Space Dwarves. And the Attacker and Assassination. Okay. So, I'm up against Orcs this time. That'll be interesting. So, what I'm really starting to say, there's a bunch they can do. We'll have to wait and see which ones they do add. Guilty Gun. Welcome to the stream. But, I don't know. I don't know if there's any really I'd be excited about. I guess there's technically Dark Eldar, too. You could add, again, not sure how they were different from regular Eldar on tabletop. I didn't really get into the, never got into the nitty-gritty of the actual rules. But, plenty of additional fleets that, could be added. And, unfortunately, we're just gonna have to sit around and wait. Be impatient gamers about it. So... Hoop! Pardon the hiccups, everyone. Excuse me. Oh, ow. So we're gonna have the opposite problem here, is that I'll be able to catch the guy. Just not kill him. I think that's a cruiser? And he's got the upgraded heavy gun, or mega cannon, I think is what it is, in the prow. I'm sad that I don't have my four Nova cannons that I like to roll with, but, you know, we'll have to do what we can. Like I said, everyone is six, so I get good macro battery saturation fire, because they get more accurate as you get closer. So, I'll cast that, and let us be going to murder orcs in the name of the Emperor. One thing I will say about the orcs, they have the best, the Savage is amazing. The Savage is the best frigate in the game. Those things are just enemy ship death. Is this the same guy I was playing earlier?
Helm coordinates acknowledged.
And he's at least moving. I should focus the generator so it takes him longer to warp out.
Yes, Admiral.
Alright, apparently this ship has no engine flare. Some strange glitches today. More than the usual crashing.
Enemy ship sighted! Your orders?
That's a battle cruiser.
Engaging! Enemy ship sighted! Terminators!
Deep striking. Wow.
Activating tactical cogitators.
That wasn't me. Heard a Nova cannon go off. I don't know where. Alright, is this guy gonna undo tactical cogitator, or what's going on here? Are we gonna fight this whole battle in slow motion?
Ship ready!
Okay, there we go.
Your orders?
For the Emperor!
Try it.
Brace for impact. Awaiting orders. Brace for impact.
Oh, he's got two battle cruisers. Okay, that makes sense. All right. Didn't take out anything, unfortunately.
Resuming normal functions.
Okay, took out his ship.
We are the Imperial Navy!
Got a weapon too, alright. Oh, it took out a couple of weapons. He doesn't have his mega cannon, and one of his lots of heavy gun on too. Nice. Oh, welcome by the way, Roadblock. So, this is going better than I expected.
Ship ready. Acquiring new vector.
I don't know the name of this. Range.
Cruising speed set. Awaiting orders.
All right, things are going pretty swimmingly by normal standards. Me?
Yes, Admiral.
Engine destroyed. All right, focus. Those weapons.
Yes, Admiral. Underway. All ahead, full.
Ah, damn it, I didn't get it out in time.
Activating tactical cogitators.
Curses! Lost my battle.
Imperial escort destroyed.
I don't care that I lost an escort, they're expendable.
Awaiting orders.
Oh yeah, another thing, lost dwarf prince. Escorts are completely expendable. Do not think of them as otherwise. Why is he not warping out?
Your orders? For the Emperor!
There we go. That's it. Don't think it was worth losing a battlecruiser over, but what do I know? I'm not in charge of making the ships. It's not my job. Here to accomplish missions. Win battles. All that jazz. Jive. Ugh. Jive and jazz do not go in the same word. Two separate words, surprisingly enough. That's pretty good. Usually I lose more ships than that, so I'll take one ship lost. My Emperor is out of dry dock. And we're only a couple hundred away from getting a favor for it. So we keep at it. Should have it done easily today. Tonight, this evening, whatever you want to call it. So what's everybody up to today? Tuesday. Definitely doesn't feel like it. Felt like Thursday or something. I'm the Breakthrough Defender. It's Juggernaut 117 MC. So he's the Juggernaut Master Chief, I guess. Alright, don't want to bring just my battleship. So we will do that and this. Alright, so it's only 300 points, so I think there will be only two platforms. But he gets like 450 points, so could be up against like a battleship. I don't know. We will have to see. I love the look of the Adeptus Mechanicus upgrade. Defend the platform and repel the enemy. And again, I've had this complaint, but how do you defend a fixed point in space with platforms since they can just go above them? Or, like, below them? I mean, there's nothing saying they have to go through right where these two defense platforms are. You know? Doesn't really make a lot of sense. But, you know, gameplay and all that stuff. Brace for impact. I'll cast that.
Yes, Admiral.
Oh crap! Forgot to. All right. Looks
ship
like
ready.
A whole three ships.
Awaiting orders.
Okay, so I only have three. So could be a battleship, a light cruiser, and a frigate, or it could be. Two cruisers and a frigate, maybe. Could be two battle cruisers,
yes,
actually. I could be really screwed. I could be all the screwed. But, see?
Your orders!
Just have to wait and see. Okay, that's. Okay, that makes sense. So, if you haven't played with the Imperium. Macro batteries get better accuracy the closer they are, and there's a penalty beyond 3,000 K or whatever the hell kilometers, I guess, is what they're using. They don't actually give an actual measurement. It's just 12,000 units of something, I guess. But they get, like it's like 80%, like it's a 20% hit rate at like 12,000. Or something, or whatever the max range is. So in this case, it's like 6,000. But my Firestorms have 9,000 lance range because I upgraded it with the Revine lasers, and I gave them a disruption overcharge and an overload generator. So
awaiting orders.
The lances do a lot more damage at greater range. Let's see if it hits. They lost their shields.
Ship ready! Burn retros!
Alright, they targeted two. Three Dauntlesses, huh? That was not what I was expecting.
Course plotted.
That was not what
Helm
I was expecting.
Helm coordinates
at.
Acknowledged! Target locked in! Your orders!
I like my Imperial Navy thing that gets me a free Cobra gunship. Not exactly the most useful thing, but you know. What does this thing have? Okay, this one. So the Imperial platforms have heavy macro turrets.
Initiate emergency repairs.
And orcs have zap guns.
To maximum! Cruising speed set! Yes, Admiral! Engines to maximum! Execute high energy turn! Ship ready!
So, this is going rather well.
We are the Imperial Navy!
Engines...
Brace for impact. Atokuma.
So I think we've got this one pretty much.
Yes, Admiral.
Get the two ships pretty heavily damaged. It's pretty unlikely they're gonna make it back.
Brace for impact.
So probably got this one pretty much on lock.
Lock on target!
And the gauge seems to last a lot longer. I don't know if it actually is or not, but it certainly feels like it is.
Your orders! Engaging!
So Friday, hopefully, we will have Eldar, so that should change up the dynamic again. But, beyond that, all their weapons are on pretty much all prow mounted, and they have lances and like torpedoes, and I don't know that they use macro batteries of any kind. So, and they'll be even faster than Chaos, which could again prove pretty problematic for like assassination or data recovery. But let's see. Have to wait and see how that will change our dynamics. Ooh man, like one more victory, I think, and we'll have it. It's 1600. Okay, yeah. So I don't know which one I'm gonna put on it. Definitely not the Inquisition. What's this one do? It ships immunity and subordination, but it's always the... It's pretty much always the Admiral ship anyway, and I don't think they can... be subordinate, insubordinate, when in your Admiral ship. I mean... maybe? That's a mechanic as one. I don't know. It's pretty much between Space Marines and the cog. I mean, it'd probably look pretty fucking cool with the Adeptus Mechanicus one, because Space Marine favor kind of lame looking, in all honesty. But you do get plus 10 troop rating, so you know, better defense for your ship, and it gets lightning strike terminators, which do an extra have like one more chance of doing a damage. Alright, breakthrough as the attacker. We'll see how this goes. Unfortunately, the ships are kind of slow, so might not make it. So even if I don't win, a couple more battles should pretty much give us the 1600 we need. Destroy the platforms that have chains and are painted red. Because they're in our way, apparently. We need to go through this exact spot in space. The only problem is that there's four of them. So... Oh, what the... Okay. Alright, I'm gonna put him at 9. Do this. Brace for impact. Lightning strikes. Make sure we auto our cannons. I don't think there's anything else we need to do.
Waiting orders!
Alright, so he has 5 ships, and that's probably a battlecruiser. Based on 3 things at launch base. So. Let's see, but that is my guess based on what I see. Man. This Emperor battleship looks good. So he's gonna identify me. Yep, I'm already getting shot with long range lances.
Yes,
well beyond my own range.
I took him out.
That was a solid hit with a Nova Cannon. Not that it's probably gonna matter much.
Brace for impact. Yes, Admiral.
But we shall see.
Enemy ship sighted.
That's only it's a Strix cruiser.
Enemy ship sighted.
I don't know how you pronounce it.
Awaiting orders.
I don't know how to pronunciate it.
Enemy ship sighted. Ship ready. Ship ready.
Alrighty. Yeah.
Terminators. Deep striking.
So 2 cruisers, 1 frigate.
Yes, Admiral.
Not as bad as I thought it would be.
At your command. Your orders.
And I lost my Nova Cannon.
Enemy defense platform destroyed.
That thing always explodes.
Your orders.
If you're gonna lose something, it's pretty much always gonna be your Nova Cannon. Platforms are dying quicker than I expected them to.
Enemy ship sighted.
Oh, did I actually tag him with that probe? No, that was a thing.
Ship
you're on fire, of course, because why wouldn't you be?
Awaiting orders. Enemy ship sighted. I took him out. Brace for impact.
Demonic fail. I guess that's good reporting.
Your orders.
Terminators. Deep striking.
Ship ready. Brace for impact!
Alright. Not not sure if it exploded or...
We can't win this! The punishment for disobedience is death!
After, like, you do that, they don't do anything. They just sit there and get shot. God damn it. There's gotta be a glitch going on where it's just like, nope. Okay, so some things are working, but it's not moving?
Come on. Ship ready.
That was some weird, I don't know what the hell was going on there. That was a little weird. So yeah, sometimes you'll execute a captain and then your ship just sits there and it won't do anything. It's just stuck in like that warping out, you know, loop. So yeah, now that one got destroyed for no fucking reason. So game's not crashing, but it's just acting stupid. Alright, I got an upgrade for my battleship. Use our crew point, but we're not gonna. Yeah, because the upgrades cost 400. Yeah. So we're gonna just save that for now. So this game can be kind of frustrating currently. But, you know, it's getting better for sure. It's not crashing every other match, or every match in some cases, so. Definite bug improvements. That's just an old cruiser clash. And that. You're ready to go. Already 11 o'clock. There we go. He picked his fleet finally for our crap. Clash in the Stars, crash. God bless America, I can't talk. Alright, let's see if we can get in range to shoot them. Our one might be an issue. Alright, be sure to do that so you can move after you've issued an attack order and won't cancel the attack order. But I have a sneaky suspicion I'm gonna start going this way, he's just gonna go this way, and then this way, and then that way. It's just gonna be a big circle. And nothing's going to happen. Alright, come on, guy, ready up, let's do this. Do 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 do. Of Of course, he might be in the glitch where you can't deploy if you want to redeploy, and then it doesn't let you deploy more ships. So we just got to wait out the last few seconds here.
Course plotted. Your orders?
People always be taunting, man.
Orders received.
Attack this guy. Space plan works.
Awaiting orders.
Let's go that way. So yeah, if you haven't been using the toggle focusing target button, definitely do it, because then you get stuff like this. So you can issue move, and it doesn't cancel attack order, which is quite useful.
Setting course.
So that you can constantly bounce it back and forth.
Ship ready.
And, not worry about your ships, just keep going some random direction or stopped. That's two pretty good Nova hits. This far away, I'm not sure how much it's going to matter. I don't really care about those two.
Helm coordinates acknowledged.
Let's see if we can get it. Again, kind of voting towards no, but we'll see. Maybe something like the last guy and just stop dead for some reason.
Your orders.
I mean, that certainly would be convenient.
Awaiting orders. Enemy ship sighted.
Cruising speed set.
His engine get taken out. Nice.
Enemy ship sighted.
Nice.
I took him up. Yes, Admiral. Engines hot.
So that was his cruisers.
Enemy ship sighted.
Race for impact.
Whoa.
Enemy ship sighted.
Yes, Admiral.
Keep that back under control.
Damage teams, begin repairs now. Targeting enemy vessel. That's your command.
All right, let's.
Terminators, deep striking. At your command.
All right, and I'm getting really lucky with these engines. Whoa, that was a solid Nova cannon hit. Solid Nova cannon.
Your orders? Lock on target. Yes, Admiral. Damage teams, begin repairs now.
That was awesome.
Ship ready. Awaiting orders.
Insubordinate captain.
All ahead, Bull. Cruising speed set.
Now, once again, I don't know if we'll be able to catch anyone. Starting up your PC to play some. Gonna give it a whirl, are we? I have persuaded you with gameplay. I mean, that's part of the point of Twitch, isn't it? To find games you want to play and to support those people that you enjoy watching play the games that you want to play? I mean, that's kind of the whole point. Looks like I win by retreat.
Engines to maximum.
Alright, got his generators. Nice.
Cruising speed set.
I'm surprised I'm going
cruising
to win this.
Speed set. Ship ready.
Engine destroyed, deck destroyed, he has no weapons. He's on double fire.
Your orders?
Ouch. That was pretty brutal. I got really lucky though with engine hits. That's what it came down to. I got his engines on those two ships. So that really did it for me. Like I said, Lost, be sure to do tutorial. And if you're really kind of intimidated by the whole thing, play against the AI. And like, it's the same setup, just you're up against bots instead of real people. So you can, you know, try out all three within a pretty stable environment and, you know, figure out what you like, what kind of style you want to go for, and all that fun stuff. My advice, you know, obviously, you can take it for what it's worth. The bots are actually still pretty fun. I skirmished, I got a skirmish Imperial Admiral all the way up. So, I mean, it's still pretty fun. Alright, we can add a favor to our Emperor-class battleship. Now, I'm kind of torn between the Space Marines and the Admech. Not sure what I want to do here. And I'm still kind of sad that there's only two battleship types and we can't have, like, Apocalypse and Oberon and, you know, the fast, what was it, the Victory-class battleships and the fast battle. You know, there were more. I hope they add them in later, you know, just for more variety. So that, you know, can have more different fleet builds, and we're not kind of just limited. You know, you get to battleship, you only got one slot, and you've got two choices. I mean, you can't get four or five. You know, that'd be nice. But so yeah, skirmishing definitely still fun. I enjoyed it and cranked out an admiral all the way up to level 8. You'll win a lot more often, so you level up quicker. Therefore, you'll get to have all the ship types a little bit earlier. Without, if you don't do very well and you end up stuck at like level, you know, 3 or 4 for a while. So again, yeah, take my advice for what's worth. I'm no expert. Alright. I just realized one guy in here done living. Why are you done living but you're here? It'd make no sense. More ship types would be nice. The orcs have like five. They have five escort ship choices. But we've got one. Go to stats here. For the Imperials, you only got the Dauntless 1 and the Dauntless 2, so you get torpedoes or lances. For cruisers, we have a little bit of variety here. You know, got Dictator, which has torpedoes, you know, launch bays. Macro, you know, you get the Gothic, which is all lance batteries, you know, torpedo prow armament. Dominator, which has the Nova Cannon and 4 macro batteries. The Tyrant, which is plasma macro, 2 plasma macro batteries. 2 regular macro batteries and torpedoes. And then, of course, you got the standard Lunar, which is 2 lance, 2 macros, and you know, your prow. So a little bit of variety here in your cruiser setup, depending on what you go for. Then you get up to battle cruisers. Let's use one that's not blown up. Then you've only got the Overlord and the Mars. And the Mars is kind of your all-rounder. It's got a little bit of everything. You've got the Nova Cannons, you got Lance Turrets, Macro Batteries, and Launch Bays. Which, there we go. No, that's Macro Battery. There we go. Ordnance Launch Bays, which means fighters, bombers, and assault craft in this case. Not, like, missiles. And then you have the Overlord, which is, you know, Prow Torpedoes, Lance Turrets, and Plasma Macro Batteries. And then, of course, sadly, we get up to battleships, and we have Retributions, which, you know, you got three dorsal lance turrets and six plasma macro batteries with torpedoes. Prow, and the Emperor has two heavy plasma macro batteries, four launch bays, and then three heavy macro turrets. But it doesn't have any prow armament. But it does have a 10,000 detection range as opposed to the 5,000 of the Retribution, so it sees further, but stats are pretty much identical beyond that, and the Emperor is a little slower at 112 as opposed to 150. So if you have an Emperor, you're going to be slowing your fleet down a smidge, which, you know, might not be good, because a lot of these game types really depend on speed more than, you know, you gotta get to the targets quickly. Alright, but back to my decision here. I mean, if I do that, it gets cheaper to fix, and it gets an upgrade, or it gains a skill slot. Which, I mean, that's nice. I mean, I could put another skill on it. But I'm not sure what I would do. Probably do like a stasis bomb or something, but we take this. Let's see. Yep, it adds one assault action to the lightning strike. So I mean, and then of course you get plus 10 to troop value. Okay, I checked the link. Why doesn't? Well, just put it in a whisper, dude. There you go. Problem solved. The Nightbot won't yell at you. But that was pretty funny. I actually went and checked it. It says deleted, but you can totally click on it and it'll bring it up. But I'm still torn on what I'm gonna put on. I want to put a favor because I want my battleship to look cooler. But I don't know which one I want to use. Because, I mean, the Inquisition one's dumb for a battleship. Ooh, I get one free crew point. Yay! And the Imperial Navy one? I mean, it's going to be your... If you take the battleship, it's going to be your admiral ship, so it's going to be immune to insubordination anyway, so what's the point? And I still wish it wasn't a cobra. I wish it was at least like a sword or something. But not the greatest perk, so really you've got Space Marines... So it's plus 10 troop value. I mean, you do get to, you know, see unlimited range. You get to see one ship, which is cool. And I have a ship with it, and my Dictator has the Inquisitorial perk, favor, whatever. But yeah, not on an admiral ship. It's stupid. And again, the Imperial Navy one, also dumb, because... If you take a battleship, it's going to be your admiral, so. Well, the Navy one's kind of wasted because it's already immune to insubordination. So, I mean, as being the admiral ship, so there's no point. You know, you lose half the value, so all you get out of it is like a free cobra. I mean, I don't know that that's really worth it. So, I'd probably go with the Admech. Just because that extra skill slot's a big deal. You do it for the Cobra. Fuck the Cobra. It's a piece of shit, and you know it. It's the worst. I'm going to go out on a limb and say it's the worst frigate in the entire game. Why? Oh, because they're immune to insubordination. Because orcs seem to cause insubordination a lot. Is that a perk they have or something? Because that seems to be something that happens a lot when you're fighting orcs. It's like, and everyone ran away. I was gonna look at the troop value. So it's just, so they, does everyone just have 60 troop value? I guess so. I thought, you figure a bigger ship would have a higher troop value, since, you know, you got more, you know, you got more randoms to throw. So I guess it's gonna be a boom, Adeptus Mechanicus battleship. Ooh, man, this looks cool. All right, well, ta-da! This looks pretty epic. So if I replace this with a Retribution, does that mean that I'm stuck? I gotta pay 1600 for the other, for the favor again? Do you know? I don't want to like replace it and then I have to find out. You know what? I'm gonna do it down here. Screw this dictator. I want another Dominator. It's Nova Cannons for the win. Oh, cool. It actually keeps the favor, too. Their battle cruisers are like the same size as cruisers. Because they've only got they're basically upgunned cruisers. That's why they're called battle cruisers. Oh, also, I just answered my own question. You lose the skills, but you do keep your points. You just have to put them in. Oh, it only did it because it doesn't have Squadron Sergeant. That's okay. Master Gunner. Okay. Yeah. They're not supposed to be close in size to battleships? No, that wouldn't make a lot of sense. But, again, what it does, as we've talked about many, many times, 40k is nothing but inconsistent about everything. So, I mean, battleships are from anywhere from like 3 to, what, 7 or 15 kilometers long. An escort can be up to, you know, a Cobra gunship's almost a kilometer long. Oh, there it is. I was like, where is it? And where are the Grand Cruisers? That's what I want to know. I want to see I had it right on the tip of my tongue, I forgot. Repulsive Grand Cruisers. Yeah, the Chaos is not supposed to have battle cruisers. They are supposed to have by the way, battleships, when you write a designation for battleship, it's actually BB. So it'd be like BB3. Why? I don't know. But it's not BS, it's BB. Just like cruisers or CV, light cruisers or LC. And then you've got destroyers, aka what we call escort ships in this case, would be DD. Though they don't really make a distinction between, in this case, they don't make a difference between a destroyer and a frigate, even though they're technically different. Yeah, seriously. Like, you've never seen, like, the old, when you're talking about a battleship, yeah, it's BB. I don't know why, but that's what it is. I ain't yanking your chain. So yeah, BB equals yeah. Snooze pretty much has it because it's naval terms, and somebody a long time ago decided that's what it was going to be, and it never got changed. BC would be battle cruiser, and then Yep, BB equals battleship. Correct. And you've got BC, battle cruiser, DD, destroyer. I don't know what frigate is off the top of my head. I know it's different than destroyer because they're different classes, but I don't know what it is. I'm the convoy attacker. I should attack with just a battleship. What's CV? Is that heavy cruiser? Is that what I'm thinking of? Or is that carrier vehicles? Oh, CVs are carriers, aren't they? Oh, FF is free. There we go. That's it. I was like, I know destroyers and frigates are different in naval terminology for Earth. Though in the Imperium, they don't seem to really make the distinction. They're pretty much used interchangeably. Yeah, there we go. CV is carrier. I knew I was misremembering something. Snooze, you got either Google, or I say you've probably got Google since you know you're on the internet, like the rest of us. But you also either have that or the knowledge. Say, what are you like? What are you, a naval man? What are you, a squid? And if I remember correctly, they were just based on when things were made and came into service. So like CV1 was the Langley for America. I guess I gotta be specific since years of naval games. That works too. Pretty much the same thing as having Google.
Helm coordinates acknowledged.
Alright, found them. Navy Field and World of Warships.
Changing course.
World of Warships has been fun. I've been playing that off and on. I streamed that last week sometime. I was doing some streaming. I was trying out the the Russian cruisers. Only got up to like two. It's anything that's cruiser or light cruiser and above is what they consider line ships. Like Google in your head.
Course plotted.
I'm gonna be really upset if that's them over there.
At your command. Underway. Engines hot.
World of Warships is bad. Just because it's like, it just introduces just, you know, 5, 6, and 8 are the best Russian crew.
All ahead full.
I'd have to get through 3 and 4 first. And I'm not sure, but it certainly seems like the gauges for the Imperial seem to be lasting a ton longer. How does he have so many more points?
Brace for impact.
Awaiting orders.
Enemy ship sighted.
And there's one.
Yes, Admiral. Changing course.
Yeah, I mean, that's usually true. I just got frustrated because I was playing like crap.
We are the Imperial Navy.
I used to be so much better.
Ship ready.
Man, this thing just likes to lose its prow cannon, I guess.
Awaiting.
Does not want to keep its lance. That's the thing, I get distracted every time I get a new fleet comes out, so it's just like, I never end up getting further than like, you know, I got an 8 for my Japanese fleet finally.
Your orders?
Engines to maximum!
At your command. For the Emperor.
So, and then I have a German 4 that I want to eventually turn into a 5, but you know, that'll take about a year.
Engaging.
Okay, the third one's probably this over here then. Oh, I don't know. Again, be sure you use this toggle force.
We've lost
focus fire.
An escort ship. Targeting enemy vessel.
Well, I guess that's pretty true. It's like in World of Tanks, I think actually some of the most fun is like at tier 3. Tier 3 is fun as hell.
Course plotted. We are the Imperial Navy.
Or about.
Cruising speed set.
Time to run. 6 to 8, huh? He seems to have a lot more points than me. So he had 2 full cruisers. Escape! Discretion is the better part of valor. Still not a fan of convoy attack or defender, because it's pretty hard to win as the defender. And then, you know, either... Yeah, that's a good point. Yeah, he can have 2 cruisers. Is there like 150? I thought you got less points as the defender, because you had the... Yeah, whatever. 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 Whatever, we're here to play. Not worry about it. Let's see. Like in World of Tanks, I got up to tier 9. I just haven't bothered to grind up to a tier 10. God, that game has changed so much since I started playing. Yeah, the combo ships don't actually count. Yeah, I know. They do help, though. They can definitely add some firepower. Breakthrough Defender. Yeah, I'm not going to bring a battleship, but I will bring that. Oh, right, because Chaos Cruisers are cheaper than mine. That's right. You are correct on that, Snooze. I forgot that their cruisers were cheaper. I was like, wait, but theirs are 155? But they're 155. I was like, no, wait, I'm dumb. They're like 143 or something. Some random number. Is a random number. Ugh. And now I'm the only one streaming Battlefleet Gothic. Ooh. It was like that earlier. There was nobody streaming earlier when I was getting ready to stream. Jesus, that's pretty good. My World of Tanks is like at 48% or something, but I have nowhere near that many battles either. I played World of Warplanes for about 10 seconds and just was like, not my thing. So I said, screw that. You're purple. You have to translate that into English for me. Assault boats. Walk on tire. Brace for impact. Plus 20% armor. Lightning strike. Okay, let's remember to actually do this time. That's my defense platforms. Alright, up against Chaos. I don't think this time he's just going to run 3 light cruisers at me. We can hope, but probably not. Fighters. Okay, that was all I had.
Changing course.
Sadly, no. He brought 5 ships this time.
Course plotted. Targeting enemy vessel.
Oh, purple. Okay. The XVM mod. I don't use mods, partly because I'm dumb and I don't know how to install them. And partly just because I don't care. I'm there to have fun. Not worry about, you know, be a little, you know, worried about all my stats.
Awaiting orders.
You know?
Ship ready.
But, you know, to each their own. There's nothing wrong with competitive play. If I were, could be a good player, or, you know, took the time to really do it, that'd be different, but...
Orders received.
For the most part, I just don't take the effort, time or effort.
Ship crippled, Admiral.
Huh? Oh. It said ship, but it really meant platform.
underway.
They're different. You don't have to call them the same
we
thing.
We are the Imperial Navy.
Orders received.
All right, if we could, yeah, I don't know. Spot, there we go. Can we spot the enemy, please? Engines.
Brace for impact.
Awaiting orders. Understood.
Of course I lose my generator.
Brace for impact.
Who on your team is worth supporting? Yeah, but I mean, generally the stats don't tell you everything.
Deep striking. Engaging. At your command.
But yeah, to each their own. And like I said, I'm not angry that people want to do stuff like that, you know? It's their call.
On target. Course plotted.
Target locked in.
Is that a light cruiser? I think so. But oh, Stim Drone, welcome to the stream. Didn't mean to
engines
seem like I was ignoring you there. Apologies. I want to say though about World of Warships, it's a very punishing game. It punishes your mistakes very harshly. If you screw up and make a bad choice, you're gonna die for it, pretty much. Oh, good. Yeah, you can warp those two cruisers out. That's cool. That's fine by me.
Yes, Admiral.
Donkey out.
Execute high energy turn.
Engines hot.
We are the Imperial Navy.
No, not you.
Acquiring new vector.
Whoops, that's not.
Ship ready.
Oh, he's warping out. Wow. It's hard
for the Emperor.
Wow, that was crazy. That was an unexpected win. I'll take it. But like I said, World of Warships, if you just you get a little cocky, you roll up around something, you're just gonna get blasted in the fucking face at the time. So, very harsh game. It will not coddle you. And like in World of Tanks, you can like, if you make like a bad choice, you can sometimes get out of it, and, you know, unless you just get, you know, totally wrecked, which does happen, but you know, not as often. But not sure how useful that. Well, I guess then they can't target you. So there's some use in that. Let's see, we can drop plasma bombs, disruption bomb. Bombers and assault boats negate, or assault craft, negate shields, so there's that. Don't want to do that. Target ship cannot use maneuvers and is forced to attack the ship at its engagement range for 15 seconds. Don't really want to draw fire onto my Emperor-class battleship. You know what? I'm going to go with auger disruptors. Something a little different. Upgrades cost 400. Man, battleships are expensive. And Britain just had to go and make HMS Dreadnought and make it even more expensive. No, there are some times when, you know, there are straight up just, you know, bad, you know, either, you know, bad players or just, whatever. There are bad players, don't get me wrong, it's not always the game, but I'm saying, like, if you're trying to be, you know, kind of sneaky, you know, like thinking you got a good move, but you don't. You know, that's just a bad move, you know. Sail into three enemy battleships by yourself, that's dumb. And not the game, but, you know. If you miscalculate where the enemy's gonna be, or, you know, what they're planning, you just eat a bunch of torpedoes or something. Very unsatisfying. Nothing more satisfying on the other end is dropping torpedoes and thinking you're gonna miss and hitting like the ship behind the guy you actually fired him at with like two of them. Alright, well that is a... Why would you do that? Why would you put a defense platform right next to a big structure? I mean, hello, blind spot. Well, I mean, they are fire magnets. It's kind of the point, though. They're supposed to kind of draw fire. But, I mean, I can kind of see where the complaint is. The gameplay is much slower in ships than it is in, like, tanks. So it's a lot less dynamic in that regard. So you spend a lot more time getting to grips with the enemies. Oops, I keep getting to do that. Did he split up? Yes, he did. I guess I can see that as a strategy, but I'll just wait till they get a little bit closer.
Awaiting orders! At your command!
And... at least one of those is a light cruiser.
Yes, Admiral!
Alright, he has that, Nurgle-like favor or whatever. Not Nurgle, but one of them. Your game didn't start. Well, that's unusual.
Awaiting orders.
Nope, that's a valid point.
Your orders.
It's a valid point, Snooze. You lose sight of something for a second, a destroyer gets right up on top of you, and you're exploded. And then suddenly, you were dead.
Enemy ship sighted!
Woof! Three Nova Cannons smacks right in the face. So what is over here? Probably at least another light cruiser or cruiser. It looks to be probably split up between two cruisers.
Ship ready!
Oh, and there we go. Yep. Hey, we've had our first crash. And it took a lot longer than I thought it was going to. Yeah, it'll do some dumb things sometimes. Oh, I didn't even realize I had crew points here. Always good to use those. Master gunners. Always want to upgrade my squadrons. The game's a lot less crashy than it has been, though. So, I mean, I'm saying the crash issues are coming along, fixing those bugs. Coming along quite nicely. But Lost, you're going to just probably have to open it a couple of times. And give it time. It takes a minute for it to load up. Boy's going to get me. It's a 700-point cruiser clash. Oh, boy. This should be interesting. It sucks that battleships... Why is there not more than 700 points? Why don't we have like a, you know, 950 or something? So that you can have, you know, a battleship, two battle cruisers, and then like two cruisers. Interesting. I don't know about that one. Holy crap, there's eight people in my stream! A Google? It's a Google. I like the look of my new. I like the new paint job my battleship's sporting. Alright, so. So this battlefleet looks a little silly with, you know, a battleship, two battlecruisers, and then two frigates. Not exactly a good battle group makeup, if you ask me, but, you know, I'm only supposed to be the one in charge of this fleet. That, and we'll do that now with our new sweet skill. Definitely don't want to auto micro warp jumps, because Lord knows where the stupid captain's.
Awaiting orders.
Fighters.
Setting course.
So, welcome everybody to the stream. Thanks for joining us tonight. So, I've basically been playing like Battlefleet Gothic, Mordheim, and Orcs Must Die lately. That's been my three games. Holy crap. 37 ships? Jesus criminy.
Enemy ship sighted!
So there's a battleship. It has the Grot cannon, so it's a bad moons. Yeah, the sad thing is you'll spend the first, you know, 20 minutes or so in tutorial, but, you know, that's just. Is orc stuff cheaper than mine? That was two pretty solid.
At your command.
That was two pretty solid Nova Cannon hits there. All things considered.
Changing course.
Alrighty. I'm just glad this game doesn't crash every 5 seconds like it has been the past month or so. Major improvements have been made to game stability, apparently. Man. So orc ships are definitely cheaper than mine. Seriously, these fighters are ugly. The orc fighters look way better.
Targeting enemy vessel.
I mean, I had that, you know, what happened a couple of seconds ago where it just dropped me back to the main menu, essentially.
Engage.
Way better. Oh, Jesus Christ. Really? Because, I mean, he's got more, but I get two. Oh, he took a light cruiser. Okay. I'm seeing
yes,
now.
Admiral.
Should focus weapons on orc ships. Less DACA is better for.
Activating tactical cogitators.
I thought they were cheaper. Like, I could be misremembering it, but I did play them for a little while at least.
Brace for impact. Targeting enemy vessel. Yes, Admiral.
Wow! Insubordinate captains all over the place. Why do you? All right, pro tip: if you're playing orcs, your first upgrade needs to be squeak pens, because one insubordinate captain and two just jumped out. There's only one of his captains left of his line ships. So I've essentially won this match already.
Acquiring new vector.
Cruising speed set.
So,
at your command.
Again.
Target locked in.
Yeah. You need squig pens, so. No, yeah, and he wasn't using his escorts. Then he wants to complain that the game is shit. It's like, or you're just playing like crap, dude. Game's actually really good. It's fun. Yeah. It's pretty engaging. There's a lot of different varieties of strategy.
Yeah.
Even with only three fleets, you know, but we're getting there. There will be more.
Cruising speed set. Engines hot.
Alright, there's one.
Cruising speed set.
But yeah. Don't blame the game for, you know.
Yes, Admiral.
The mechanic of that is mentioned. That orcs captains are very insubordinate. So again, pro tip for orcs. If you're playing orcs, get a ship, you put squig pens on it. And that's how, you know, you get to execute your captains. But you do a ton of damage. It's just bad rolls.
Targeting enemy vessel.
So, just. That's what happens sometimes. So yeah, that was just bad on him. I'll take that. That was good. That was a good win for me. I'm the best. I'm the winner. Yeah, he wasn't. It's like aggressively attack. That's how you play orcs. Alright, so that was a fun little excursion back to my Imperial fleet. Oh, it even changed the angel color to, like, stone colored. But, yeah, so if you're taking anything away from the stream today, pro tip for orc players, get squig pens so you can execute your shitty captains. Pro tip that you definitely need. So, for sure, need those on your ships for the orcs. Alright everybody, sorry for the short stream today, Lost. I hope you enjoy a game. Dive into it. Don't get too, you know, make sure you get some sleep, eat food, you know, all that good stuff. But thanks everybody for coming by real quick to hang with me tonight. Gotta cut it short, gotta get up early tomorrow for school. Yay, college! So much fun, guys, isn't it? But thanks for coming by. If you haven't, give me a follow so you can know when I'm, you know, streaming. I'm trying to do it pretty much every day, but with a few exceptions. Follow the link over to my YouTube channel to watch previous streams, get my, you know, original content. Just started my playthrough for full play of Knights of the Old Republic. I definitely want to do the second one. It's going to take forever, though. But thanks for stopping by. Again, be sure to give me a follow. And subscribe over my YouTube channel for me. Really help me out, guys. And thanks for all the fun. This game is definitely coming along. A lot of bugs fixed. A lot of fun. And we are looking forward to Eldar probably Friday. So we'll have a fourth fleet. So be a lot of new strategies coming to light to see how we handle the quick and deadly Eldar. But anyway. Thanks for the good times, and I'll see you guys on the next stream. Alrighty, good night, everybody.